Hello everyone. So this is my first tutorial on system Verilog. I will be covering concepts related to system Verilog. System Verilog is important for verification, even for programming languages like Verilog. So Verilog is a hardware descriptive language. What is system Verilog? System Verilog is designed to test that hardware. Okay, so we are testing a system by using a Verilog language. So Verilog language has some limitations. That's why people came across with the term system Verilog, where we have included the OOPS concept in system Verilog. Okay, so there are some chapters related to system Verilog. System Verilog itself has an LRM which you can download. Okay, it's available from Axelera systems. If suppose you go gradually, right, you will realize that it is very deep, and people actually live in between system Verilog. They just try to learn in middle something on that, right? They don't try to learn it very quickly, and they just work around the problems. They don't just go in depth on system Verilog. So that's the bottleneck. Everything is available in internet, that's sure. But you need some hands-on on system Verilog so that when you are doing the real programming, right, when you are in the design team, when you are in the verification domain, or you're designing some projects, or you want to test your processor, you want to test your system, okay? Whatever systems you have designed, which can be tested with system Verilog languages, you can do it, and with confidence, with ease, okay? So most of the systems now, when it is designed, right, it's very difficult to test it like step by step. Like suppose you designed a simple 3-bit adder, right? What are the possible checkers? Possible checkers are like you test from 000 to 111, and you will have all your answers, right? There is a scenario that is also possible when any of the input can be X, any of the input can be Z. Okay, so you can have more combinations of inputs. You're getting so one suppose variable. It can have four values, 0, 1, X, and Z. Z means it's a floating point, right? So there is nothing, no one is driving that net. Okay? X means two systems may be driving the particular net, so it is in some ambiguous range. So suppose something is 0 to 5 volts. Suppose 0 means so everything in analog system is in range, right? So like suppose I will say 0 to 5 volts, right? So 0 to suppose 1 volt will be treated as 0. 5 volts to 4 volts treated as 1, but between 1 to 4 there is the ambiguity range, right? That is nothing but x state. We are not sure whether it is 0 or whether it is 1. Okay, so in a way they are simple 3-bit adder, right? It can have so many combinations possibility, right? So that's the problem, right? How will you test that? So you need some programming languages so that you can check simple adder. Okay, you can say, okay, sir, 3-bit adder, we can have all the combinations possible, right? But what about the systems which are like more complex now? Okay, so in digital designs, generally we go for system Verilog. There are more depth things available, like real number modelings and other stuffs which are available. Like analog system can also be designed in terms of digital ways. We will cover it one by one, right? First I will just try to tell you concepts on system Verilogs, gradually we will move forward to more in-depth things, right? So in system Verilog, we will start with very basics, very, very basics, okay? And gradually we will move forward. So what I've done here is, I have programmed that stuffs, okay? I'm showing you the results. So when you're revising, it may help you to quickly revise it. When you want yourself to test the system, right? You can test it very quickly. So that is the helpful in this thing, and it's like a video. You can just watch it anywhere, anytime, right? You can make it like 2x speed, and you can just watch all the things, whatever is possible. Please leave the comments if you find that I'm speed lectures, or I'm not in clarity in English, or you want some more depths on that thing, right? So that will also help me to learn. Okay, so I'm not very 100% like UVM master or system Verilog master. I'm myself learning. I will learn with you guys as well. Okay, so let's start with the concepts. So first I will explain the difference between reg and wire, right? So reg it's self-resistant, right? Registers. You have understanding your macro systems when you studied, right? Registers which hold the information. So in Verilog also there's a reg, right, which holds the information, right? So suppose you have written zero, it will have that zero information at infinite time of time also. It will hold that information. What about the wire? Wire is like your electrical circuit. So as long as power is available, it will have that value. Otherwise, it will lose that value. So you will say, sir, resistor also can lose the value when power is not there. Yeah, true. But it's like a memory. Once you get back the power, it will have that value. Okay. So I'm showing an example in the hardware descriptive language. So you see module I've given and I've declared wire X and reg Y. So I'm just showing you the default values for both the things. Default value is X. X means it's ambiguous state. Okay. There are more data types like integer. The range is 2 to the power of 31 to 2 to the power of 31 minus 1. Okay. And this will be minus here. Okay. And real numbers, it's like 64 bit floating quantities. So general notations we show, like suppose some value is 1.2 e 10, right? So it is like 1.2 into 10 to the power of 10. That is the real value. So e is like a scientific notation. Then there is a data type called as time, okay, which is again a 64 bit quantity, and generally we use the system task to hold the real time value. So you don't say time like your real time, like suppose 7:30 p.m. is now time. You don't say it that way. You say like the simulation started at 0 nanoseconds. The simulation, when it is completed, it has supposed run for 1 microsecond. You will say 1000 nanoseconds. The simulation has completed. So suppose you want to check. Suppose a signal is oscillating at say 1 milliseconds, right? And you have run for 10 milliseconds. So how many cycles it has completed? 10 cycles it has completed, right? So you can use the time variable to check the peaks value. So different peaks you will try to measure and you will say, okay, it has completed 10 cycles. So in that way, you can write a programming language using just simple time. You can use the time to check where your simulation has stopped. Okay. So suppose you are publishing dollar time every time and you see somewhere, okay, it is giving some ambiguous state or simulation has stopped. So you can just go to that time, right? And you can see, oh, it has stopped at this particular time. It means my simulation is completed till this point. Okay. So you can just go there, debug system where it is wrong, right? So time can be used in multiple ways, right? It can be used to verify. It can be used to know when your simulation is completed. It can be used to debug as well, right? There is a data type like parameter. Parameter is like you want to have constant value, right? So suppose you say something is 10, but it has some importance in program, right? So you just put up like a parameter and you say like X is equal to 10, right? That X is a variable, but that is having a constant value. So that constant value can change by using def parameter. Okay, so suppose in another program you're calling another program, right? So there you can write def parameter I dot something, right? Is 20. So you can modify it there. But as when simulation is running, right? After compilation and elaboration, when simulation is running, there you cannot change it. You can change only in the compilation stage. Okay, so that is a parameter. We'll go in more depth on these things, right? Just I'm explaining you like how you can use it. So next program I have written is like this way, module behave data types. So I'm just showing you like default values of this. So default values for integer is X, for real number is 0. For time, I'm showing you time is 0. Okay. Logic, that is X. Okay. Logic is nothing but like just like reg and wire. Now you say the wire logic has come up. So logic data type has come. So like in behavioral language, right, there are two aspects, right? You have something called as behavioral modeling and something called as continuous assignments modeling, right? So you say reg can be used only in the behavioral models, like always blocks, right? There you can use the reg variables. Wire can you be used, variable can be used only in the assigned continuous operator. So logic has come up where you can use it in both cases. It doesn't matter. You want to use it continuous assignment, you can use it. You want to use it behavioral models, like behavioral modeling style, there also you can use it instead of always block also. So that's why logic. Okay. So here I'm just displaying the default values. Okay. Next. So here I am just trying to change the parameter value at the simulation time. So you see parameter P1 is equal to 10 I have written, and I'm just trying to change this P1 is equal to 20. So what you are getting is parameter is not a legal L value. It means it cannot be changed at the simulation phase. Yeah. So you, once you have fixed, you cannot change it. Right. So that's why this 14 line number was showing that error in the top. And here, again, I'm just displaying like normal value. So you can see real variable like R is equal to 1.2 E10. That is nothing but shown as 1, 2, and that 9 zeros. Right. So that is what it is. Okay. So we will have very short lectures so that it doesn't take too much of your bandwidth in one lecture. Right. We will have like tutorials for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes maximum. Right. 20 minutes. That's it. That's the bottom line. So I will try to wrap up lecture like 10 minutes, 15 minutes so that it becomes short. You will have many lectures to go through and it will be precise to the point, and you will have programming languages in parallel with it. You just don't have the theory in between, right? You have the results in parallel. So this is how we are going to work on it. Okay. So thanks for your time and hope you will continue to watch these lectures. Thanks.